Before starting, shortly I will talk about myself. I am from Turkey and I live in Sparta city. And I am a mathematician. I work as a faculty member in Süleyman Demirel University. I have done my PhD under the supervision of Steph Weiss. He is one of, as most of you know, he is one of the leading scientists in game theory. And my PhD thesis topic was cooperative interval games. And by following his great experience and intuition, we were able to succeed on the extension, on this extension. Today I will give a brief explanation on this topic because it's a huge theory. Title is Cooperative Interval Games and Their Potential on Economic and Operations Research Situations. First of all, I have to give or I have to talk on classical cooperative games to give you more or less an insight about what we have done in the extension, the similarities and differences. So I will speak a bit on classical case, and then I will pass to the basic theoretical parts on cooperative interval games. After that, interval solutions, and then in this theory, we are proposing interval solutions to the players. But after everything game ends, let us say, we found a way to propose the players classical solutions. It is handling interval solutions. We pass from the interval case to the classical situation. We have an algorithm, and I will briefly mention about it. After that, from the title also you saw, some a little bit on economic situations and operations research situations with interval data. And the theory of cooperative interval games helped me to construct a similar theory by using gray numbers and fuzzy interval numbers, also with ellipsoidals, similar structure. Little bit, if I have time, little bit, I will also talk about this concept. As a motivation, game theory in general, game theory is a mathematical theory dealing with models of conflict and cooperation. And it has, in literature, it has a huge, a lot of, let us say, papers related with economics and operations research situations. But compared with the other mathematical theory, theoretical result, it's a young field of study. The start is considered to be the book of theory of games and economic behavior by von Neumann and Morgenstern in 1944. Now, we have two parts, but I will talk on the cooperative part, of course, non-cooperative and cooperative, basically. Basically, theory we can divide, and today's topic is cooperative case. In cooperative game theory, the players deal with coalitions who coordinate their actions and pool their winnings. And we have rewards or costs according to the model it changes. Our main problem is to share or to allocate, let us say, to allocate these rewards or costs in a fair way. Fair division is important for us. And as you know, we have a classical theory, and in this theory, everything is deterministic. But our motivation comes from real life situations. In real life, the things are not deterministic. And to solve this problem, there exists there exists some theory depending on probability or stochastic case, but our way is different from this theory. We don't have any probabilistic distribution in our studies. We are just working on real numbers. I think I talk about this, our motivation. Our aim is try to generalize and extend the classical theory, or Christ theory, let us say, taking the beliefs of the coalitions as real numbers. We try to generalize and extend this theory as much as we can, and try to use this theory on economic and operations research situations. This is the classical definition. A cooperative M person came in coalitional form. We have an ordered pair, N is the set of players, and V is the characteristic function here assigning to each coalition. These are the coalitions 2 to the power N, assigning to each coalition to a real number. And we define the value of the empty set as 0. Vs is the value of each coalition. We can also say the worth of the coalition of the set, subset or set, we can say. And the family of this games, cooperative games, is shown by as a notation Gn. And it is a linear space. It forms a linear space. And of course, if it is a linear space, it should have a basis. And this basis is one of them for reward games. We call it as unanimity games. Here it is shown as an ordered pair, N, and this time instead of V, we show with U, V. Here it means that here this definition U, T, S, if T is a subset of S, then there's a gain because players cooperate with one. If not, it is 0. So as an interpretation, we can say that UT, the unanimity game UT, is a gain of 1 can be obtained if and only if all players UT are involved in cooperation. If not, they don't gain anything. And so the cooperative games, all the cooperative games can be written in terms of unanimity games. This is just a calculative example, calculation, let's say, a simple illustration of this topic. If, for example, if we have a two-player game, the worth of the player one is 3, worth of the player one is 4. If they cooperate, it is 9. And we can write it in terms of unanimity games. And if we check, for example, for V1, if one is a one subset of one, yes, it is correct. So we take it as 3, but 2 is not subset of 1. Then we take it as 0. And also similar for 1, 2, and 1, if we compare them, its value is also 0. And we obtain 3. And others can be done easily by following this way. Equality is also included. Here the subset or equal to. Here we show the same notation, so one subset of one, they are equal to each other, so we say okay, it is one, the result is one. And core is one of the core topics as a solution concept in cooperative games. It is a set value solution concept, and in general for n person games it's a polytope. And here we have a payoff vector X. This payoff vector should satisfy here. First one is with equality efficiency condition. So efficiency condition should be satisfied for a solution to be in the core. And also here, as you can see, X, sum of Xi, I is in S, should be greater than or equal to Vs, mean that if an allocation is in core, we give every allocation at least their worth, at least Vs we give them. So players are contributing or cooperating, let us say, cooperating to the game if this allocation is in core. Both efficiency and stability, coalitional stability we call. Here is just one example. This is a specific example. In most of the books of game theory, both in non-cooperative case and cooperative case, this flow game situation, or glow game can be found. I just again give a simple example, and I will show it is interval case also. Here there are three players, and we assume that two players owns or produces left-hand glove, and one player produces right-hand glove, and they need each other to own something, so they have to cooperate, because single glove worth nothing. So we form the characteristic function, the values of the coalitions as follows. Here, player three can be seen as a big boss, but alone, also without one or two, player three also can gain nothing. And when player three is included here, one, three, and two, three, it is 10. Also for VN, it is 10 because we have just here the simplest example. We have just one pair of gloves. So two, three, one, three, and one, two, three has the same value. And for one and two, it is clear, I think, because without player three, they gain nothing. And this is a normally in general, core is a polytop, as I told. And for a three player case, it can be sometimes a triangle, sometimes trapezoidal or so. It can be extended. But here, for a glow game, it is just 1 point. Big boss takes everything, 0, 0, 10. In general, for n-person games, in algorithmic game theory, the core can be calculated easily by using linear programming from optimization theory. It can be done. We just find the extreme points of the core. And it is a system of in a linear and linear equalities and inequalities. So extreme points can be calculated easily. This calculation given by Bondareva and Shapley is also an important characterization that we also have done in the interval case. Core sometimes can be non-empty. Core can be empty. So in which situations core is non-empty, this characterization gives us. If we have a balanced game, and the core is non-empty, or other direction, if core is non-empty, game is balanced. And balancedness has a simple formula. This inequality is satisfied, related with a positive scalar. We have a positive scalar. Then it is a balanced game, which makes the core non-empty. This is also, again, basic preliminary Sulam classical theory, which we need in Shapley value and also in the extension of extension for the extension to the interval case. I will also show you the difference. Marginal contribution of a player. When we have a game, a cooperative game V, marginal contribution of player I for the coalition S means everyone, including I, is in the game has a value. We subtract the value when I is not included to this coalition S. And what remains? The contribution of player I remains. So this is marginal contribution. And for Shapley value, we have a marginal contribution vector with similar idea. This time, we check for every ordering. So we need permutation. We check every permutation. According to each permutation, we look at the contribution of the player to the game, and we obtain the marginal contribution vectors. Here is just a simple example to calculate marginal vectors. Again, we have a three-player case here. For example, let us show 2, 1, 3. For three-player case, we have 6 permutations. For example, for 2, 1, 3, what it means? First of all, player 2 comes to the game. Then its value here is given as 0. So the contribution is 0. After that, first player comes. And when first player comes, we will look at the value of 1, 3. It is 3. The contribution of first second player was zero, so t minus zero, it is three. So the second player takes three. And what remains to the third players? The rest, bn minus three, seven remain. By a similar idea, we calculate all of them and find the marginal contribution of all players. And then what Shapley value does? Shapley value takes the average of these marginal vectors. Here is continuation of the previous example. We divided to 3 factorial to find the Shapley value. Marginal vectors, we have another set-valued solution. It is Weber set. Weber set is the defined as the convex hull of the marginal vectors. It means that the extreme points are the marginal vectors. Extreme points of the Weber set are the marginal vectors. Here I show the glow game example. Weber set, we have for Weber set of the glow game, table, let us say, showing the marginals, we have three marginals, 0, 0, 10, 10, 0, 0, 0, 10, 0. It is scored just one point, but Weber set is the triangle as the extreme points, three extreme points. And for Shapley value, we divide it to 6 and obtain one point solution. I think this is my final slide on classical case. This I also gave because I will turn to the convex interval case, interval games part. For convexity or concavity, there exist also characterizations and similar formulas can be found to show if a game is convex or not. Here, for convex games, we have a gain, and this gain for reward games. The gain made when individuals or groups join larger coalitions is higher when they join smaller coalitions. It means that, again, there's an incentive for players to join to the bigger coalition. And therefore, convex games, there are interesting nice properties. For example, Shapley value is in the middle of the core. Core and Weber set are equal to each other. And most of the operations, research, and economic situations can be modeled as convex or concave. Concavity is for cost games. It is similar. When we have a cost game, not a game, the inequality changes. So it becomes less than or equal to. But everything that remains same. The idea is same. And here is there is a nice book of Branzai, Dimitrov, and Price, which is published in 2008 for CRISP cooperative games. Now I am passing to cooperative interval games. Here, first of all, I gave some published papers while I was doing my PhD. These papers occurred. These are the most basic papers which I still use when I am doing a case study, for example. I use the theory. Lies here. One of them is cooperative interval games. This is my thesis. It is published also as a book by Lambert Academic Publishing. Another one for cooperative interval games, a survey paper we have, giving basic ideas and basic theorems about this extension. And this one is set-valued solution concepts for interval core, interval imputation set, interval Weber set, their relation, their theoretical framework can be found. And the other one, convex interval games, is for Shapley. While extending Shapley value, we also extended this extra class, subclass. Convex interval games. The characterization of convex games to the interval setting can be found in this paper. Now I am coming to the main case, cooperative interval games. Definition. Now we have again, similar to the classical case, we have an ordered pair and we denote by W, the classical case. And it's set of players again, there's no difference. And here W is the characteristic function, but this time this characteristic function assigns to each coalition to an interval. This is a closed interval. Closed and bounded, let us say closed and bounded compact interval of real numbers, formed as real numbers. And we denote by value of the, not denote, we define the value of the empty set as 0, 0, 0. It is which call degenerate interval. If the lower bound and the upper bound equal to each other, we call it as a degenerate interval. This is zero degenerate interval, let us say. Underline S is lower bound and upper line S is upper bound. And this time we have IGN. IGN, we call it as interval games, family of interval games with players at N. And we will, in the following slides, I will use IR and IRN. IR is also here, I told. Closed and showing closed and bounded intervals in R. IRN, it is n-dimensional vectors whose elements are intervals. Now here I mentioned about a degenerate interval, but also here as a remark, I gave it as definition. If all the word intervals are degenerate, then the lower bound and upper bound are equal and the interval game corresponds to the classical cooperative game. Here I want to show the difference degenerate case and classical case. If we take Vs from an interval, this is a real number, this is a real interval, Ws. If Vs is in Ws, this is a real number. But if we have Ws, which is a degenerate interval, it is a set consisting of just one point. And here another remark we can result. The theory of crisp, I mean crisp classical, the theory of crisp cooperative games can be embedded in the theory of cooperative interval games. That is, cooperative interval games are an extension of classical cooperative game theory. Now another difference that coming. Now, this is basic interval calculus that I use. I just give addition and subtraction here and multiplication with the scalar. We have two intervals. Here you can see the notations with similar idea. This is length of an interval. This will be important in extending the theory. Length of intervals is important for us. Here we have a positive scalar, alpha, and addition and multiplication with a positive scalar is defined. But subtraction, we have a different, we have, let's say we have constructed or defined a different subtraction operator. This is, so I call it partial subtraction operator, which is defined only if the length of I, here the length of I is greater than or equal to length of J. In cooperative interval games, we need to define a partial ordering between the intervals. For in general, for every interval, it cannot be extended. If there is a partial order between the intervals, then the cooperative interval games can be extended from classical case to the interval case. Why we have done this in my following slides, I will also give it is economical explanation about subtraction operator. And with the similar idea, weakly better than and less than These are greater than or equal to, can be considered as greater than or equal to, less than or equal to of classical case. But of course, this time we have intervals. Now we are ordering the intervals. Weakly better than, if the interval I is weakly better than J, it means that the lower bounds of I is greater than or equal to the lower bound of K, and it is also similar for upper bound. And other notation is other direction, weakly less than happens. Again, I am saying we have a weakly better than notation because we have a partial order on the on these intervals. Here, arithmetic of interval games. If we have two intervals which are taken from IGN and we have a positive scalar, then we can compare them by using weakly better than notation. Addition is okay. Multiplication with a positive scalar is okay. So we have a constructor. Classical case is forms a linear space, but interval case forms a constructor operator with weakly better than operator and with non-negative scalars. We should have positive scalars. And this is coming from this partial subtraction operator we have defined. For our case, the length of the first one here should be greater than or equal to the second one. And our subtraction is defined. The game is defined. Also in the extension, we will need border games. We call border games the lower game and the upper game. These are classical. And we will also need length game. Length game, length of the, coming from the length of the interval. Now, first of all, for interval core, we don't need subtractions. This is so we define interval. We can define interval core for all IGN, let us say, interval games. For all the family of interval games, we can calculate the interval core. As you can see, if you remember, in the classical case, we had as payoffs xi's, this time we have ii's. And this is again the efficiency. First one, efficiency should be satisfied. And coalitional stability with weakly better than notation should be satisfied this time because we have intervals. And this is, I mentioned about classical glow game. You can see the simplest form of the interval glow game. This time we took as an interval, let's say interval J. If they cooperate, the value becomes J. If not, we have degenerate interval 0, 0. And we have an similar to the classical case, but this time we have degenerate intervals 0 for first player, 0 for second player, and A means that again the interval, as we propose the interval solution, big boss takes everything. But in general, in algorithmic game theory, if we want to calculate, these are simple calculations by hand, also we can solve these. And we can find these results but for n-person case, we need algorithmic game theory. And there exists a paper of calculating interval core, an algorithm written by Kims and Dressel. Here the idea is calculating by using linear programming, calculating the lower bound of the game, calculating the core of the lower bound, calculating the core of the upper bound, and combining. The idea is coming from this idea. And for general n-person interval games, core can be calculated. Extreme points of the core can be calculated. And I give the classical characterization when core is non-empty. if game is balanced, the core is non-empty. Here for the interval case, again, we were able to succeed to extend. This time we have interval balancedness, and again we have our partial order, and we compare with this partial order, we check, let us say, the intervals, and if this condition is satisfied, then the game is, the core is non-empty. So we should be in the class of interval balanced games if we want the core be non-empty, let us say, because even sometimes the core can be empty, sometimes can be 1 point, it changes. And I give the classical definition I gave, just the interval extension. A little difference here occurs. If we want a game, the convex interval game or a concave interval game. Convex for reward, concave for cost games. First of all, supermodularity, similar to the classical convex case. But this time we have to compare with weakly better than or weakly less than condition, it depends. It should be satisfied. We have to compare the intervals of the coalitions. And it is not enough. Also, the length of the game should be convex. Length is just classical case. So we have to check the classical length game. If it is also convex, we say that the game is a convex interval game. Or concave is other direction. And we define this class as CIGN, a subclass. Here, size monotonicity. Size monotony is also important, very important. When we extend the solution, including subtraction. We can only extend a solution including subtraction in size monotonic case, because in size monotonic case the subtraction is defined. We have to put some restrictions on these intervals, and also we have to define these new classes because we have to protect the nature of classical case. That's why we are doing this, we are giving these extra restrictions or extra classes. Definition, if the length game, interval game, it is one direction, not both directions. If the interval game is size monotone, if length game is monotonic, then interval game is size monotonic. Direction is coming from length game. If the length game is classical game is monotonic, then the game is size monotonic. It means that here is the mathematical definition. If S is subset of T, then the length of length game WS is less than or equal to length game of WT. And we show it as SMIGN. Here are some comparison of the classes. These are theoretical results. Interval Weber set is defined on this class, size monotonic case, because we have a subtraction operator. Idea is same, the contribution of the player, interval contribution of the players, we are calculating. And interval Weber set is again the convex hull of this interval marginals. And again, it is easy to calculate because algorithmic game theory helped us to calculate the Weber set. Here, look, I just give a counter example. We have a two player case. Let's say W1 is 1-3 and W2 is 0-0. WN 2-3.5. This game is not size monotonic. If you check, you will see it. And when we continue calculating, it is marginals. We suddenly see that M1 to W is not defined because we obtain a case which is not a, we obtain an interval which is not an interval because we have 1/2. 1 is greater than 1.5 and they should change places. So if we work in general case, this kind of intervals can occur. But if we work on size monotonic case and if we work with partial subtraction, we don't have these cases. And again, interval shapely value is defined on this size monotonic class. And here just simple calculation. We calculate the marginals, and then we take the average, and we propose interval solutions here. Now, I have a remark also. I mentioned, but I also want to write to give you a more efficient explanation, let us say. Restriction to the class of size monotonic case was imposed by the need to establish efficiency of interval marginals. Efficiency is very important in most of the solutions in cooperative game theory. So we have to protect efficiency. And if we use the subtraction in computer arithmetic Moore's subtraction, we cannot protect. So we use the partial subtraction operator. Then we face this struggle. While we are trying to extend shapely value, we need marginals, and while calculating interval marginals, we face this struggle, and then we constructed the partial subtraction. In fact, the partial subtraction operator introduced in 2009 is an essential tool in interval game theory, because by using Moore's subtraction, efficiency might be lacking. Here is the difference. In our case, for example, is 6, 8, 2, 5. Length of the first interval is 2, length of the second interval is 3. So we obtain an undefined interval. But if you continue with Moore, you can find, here is the formula, you can find an interval, okay? But this time, efficiency lacks. And then we cannot extend the theory. Now, this is, now people are saying, okay, you are using interval solutions, you are proposing interval solutions, then why don't you use probability, stochastic theory, etc. And we wanted to find, wanted to do a new thing, we wanted to construct a new approach. So, because there exists a huge theory on probability parts. But this, we wanted to continue from the real case with real numbers. I have a paper on this topic. Now I will also mention it, but simple idea. We have an algorithm here. Before cooperation starts, in our case, we have interval data. We obtain an interval game. We propose interval solutions, everything is okay. Agreement happened, and then game end, game finished. At stage two, after the joint enterprise is carried out, now we know a reward from WN because the uncertainty resolved. Now we have interval solutions. According to this R, we can obtain classical real solutions. How we did it? We did this by using the protocols used for bankruptcy situations. We used bankruptcy rules. In our paper here, you can see Branzé, Thijs, Alpers, Langeuk in 2010. The theoretical, we in detail explained the theoretical framework. Also, the algorithm, calculations, everything is included in this paper. We used the proportional rule, constraint equal reward, rewards rule, different classical cases, or the constraint equal losses rule. In our paper, we used these three cases, but it can be another rules also can be used. The detailed information on these rules can be found in Kaminsky, the papers of Kaminsky and Thompson. And just a simple example about the procedure. For example, we have this game, two-player game, 0-2, 0-1 for player 2, 1-2 for the Grand Coalition. We calculated interval shape value, it's okay. Then the game ends. We proposed interval solutions. we have this reward. I mean, game ends, uncertainty resolves, and we have six as a reward. Here I chose the proportional rule. Other rules also can be chosen, of course. Proportional rule divides according to the divides proportionally demands of the players. Let us say the players have demands, and the value we have, we call it as an estate, D as the demands. And then by using this formula, now what we will do? Now, shapely value is here, reward is here, six. Now, first, I give all the players, before use applying proportional rule, I give the players the lover case. I give player one, for example, lover, yes, lower bond, two and two. I give them the players, but what else I will give? I am using the proportional rule. I give two, two, what remained as an estate? Two is remained. And what are the demands? Demands are the length of these P1 and P2, the elements of the interval shape. Why? Because we give the lower bound, P1, and then phi1 upper, phi minus phi1 lower, when you sum, we try to give the upper. Theoretical framework is coming from this. We try to give the best to the players. So first of all, we give the lower bound, and then we use the bankruptcy rule and divide. Here is the classical solution. 3 and 1 and 1 over 4, 2 and 3 over 4. What we have done, here is our interval case. Interval, we propose the interval solution, and here is classical, which is an element here inside. First one is element of the first, second is element of the second. I think how much time I have, George?
You still have 10 minutes if you would like to leave 5 minutes for questions.
Okay. Briefly, short. I have talked about the theory. I tried to give you some insight on the theory. Here, now I will pass to economic situations, but I will not have too much time. Some papers on this economic and operations research situation based on the theory that we have developed. Case is popular, Big Boss games, classical. We have extended to Big Boss interval games. Bankruptcy situations, but this time without handling. This is another, as a situation, as an economic situation, we considered bankruptcy situations, we extend to interval case. Airport games is one of popular operations research situations we have extended. It is a concave. It's a cost game, it's a concave case, concave interval game. And sequencing situations are convex. We have shown it. Also, we try to extend the theory of sequencing situations. For the classical Big Boss games, we have this. This is which is formed by Muto and Tice. If these three properties hold in the classical case, then the game is a Big Boss game. In the interval case, I mentioned you before, we will need upper game, lower game, and the length game. For Big Boss interval games, we need lower game and the length game. If the lower game and the length game are Big Boss, these are classical game games satisfying these properties, then we can conclude that the game is a Big Boss interval game. This is marginal contribution. We are in size monotonic class here. So subtraction is defined and marginal contribution is defined. Marginal contribution is necessary for Big Boss. Here you can see in the third property we have marginal contribution. And here is another theorem showing the game, showing a characterization of a Big Boss interval game. Similar with classical case, the idea is similar, but here is the interesting part is again the partial ordering and the subtraction. So I pass quickly. We couldn't extend co-value for interval case still. But we could extend interval co-value for big boss game, because for big boss games, we have an another alternative definition for big boss games. Half of union point and big boss point gives us the tau value. So we can also calculate interval tau value. Other things are also similar with the classical case. Again, the difference is coming from the subtraction operator. Here is holding situations is an application of big boss situations. I have a simple example, so I will not talk about, I don't have enough time. A simple calculation we have done. The player three is owner of a holding house, so it is he or she is the big boss. So if big boss is included, they have a value. If not, it is zero. But if big boss is alone, again, big boss cannot gain anything. So according to the formulas that we have given, we can calculate big boss points, union points. We can calculate tau value, and also we have shown. In our big boss paper, tau value is also interval tau value is in interval core, so it is in the core. We can conclude this is also just bankruptcy situations. Here we have an estate, and there are claims of the players, and if they want more than the estate, then the system is bankrupt. There exists a theory on this topic, and again we put some restrictions. Because we have again minus signs, we have some additional subclasses, not on size monotonic, more smaller, a little bit smaller, because it also didn't work. Sometimes it didn't work on size monotonic class also. So extra subclasses we have defined, and we but this game is not convex. Classical bankruptcy games are convex, but bankruptcy interval games are not convex. They are just supermodular. We can only partially order them, but length game does not work here. Airport situations or another topic. It is a concave game. Also, interval setting, it is concave. We were able to extend it. We took interval costs as intervals. And then here, another basis for cost game, similar with the classical case. This is classical unanimity game. Here just TKs are, interval costs are here, TK, interval costs, TK, but this is classical. This allocation, without constructing a game, operational resource situations, we can also find some solutions. This is one solution for airport. And it is in. We have also shown that interval Baker-Thompson and interval Shapley-Value coincides with each other. Here are some other results. And this is a simple example, calculating just the Shapley value and Baker-Thompson and showing that they are equal to each other. This is another topic, sequencing with interval data sequencing situations. Here also another, we took just a brief explanation. We take the, we have an initial order and we have set of players. They are same with the classical case, but cost of the jobs shown as alpha are interval, and processing times are interval in our case. And here, partially ordering does not work. For work on sequencing situations, we have to take disjoint intervals. If not, it cannot be extended. And we need, similar with the abstraction case, we have to define special, different from computer arithmetic, special multiplication and division operators to extend this theory. And I pass this part. These are some solutions. Minimum cost depending three situations also from operations research case, the popular part. We have a paper on this and on this topic. We can could extend it to the interval setting, and they are convex, like in the classical case. And very short, as I told you, now I finished interval case. By using the theory of cooperative interval games, I succeeded to construct another theory, cooperative play games. This time, I used in terms of not intervals, but gray numbers. These gray numbers, again, like closed and bounded real intervals. What a gray number is? It is a number whose exact value is unknown, but the range within that the value lies is known. But the basic theory is coming from cooperative interval games. So I am, I just take here, you can see we have a partial ordering. Sorry, not partial ordering. We have an ordered pair and set of players. This time we have a characteristic function assigned to each coalition to a gray number. Gray number is taken from an interval. The idea is here. I have some published papers on this topic and also some case studies on can be on operation research and other case also, for example, economic order quantity model, etc. And finally, fuzzy, not finally, one more I have, but very small 2 minutes I need. For fuzzy interval games, I didn't start fuzzy interval games. Lina Malozzi, Calzo, and Tai started the fuzzy idea of cooperative games that I followed. Also, there exists literature for cooperative fuzzy games, which is constructed by Mars and Fletch. But our case is we just take the values of the coalitions as fuzzy intervals. What is a fuzzy interval? It is a set in R, which is compact, convex, and normal. Then we have a fuzzy interval. Malozzi and Tice with Scalzo started this. And we continued by following their way. I tried to publish some papers on this topic. And I am still continuing. I think, one more. This is just shortly when I finished my PhD. It's ellipsoidal structure from geometry. It is another big set. Also, cooperative interval games are subset of this set. This time we take the values of the coalitions as ellipsoids. I have some papers on this topic too. Why we do this? Because cooperative ellipsoidal games allow to represent players, mutual dependencies, similarities, and possible affinities to cooperate, we can say. Here are some published papers on ellipsoidal games, but I didn't continue a lot on this topic. I just find the cooperative ellipsoidal game and it is core. I have some results. And I think that's all. I thank you very much for your patience and listening to me.